This is the story. Now, we have many things to learn from this story. Who is Vishnu? Husband of Lakshmi. Wealth. Representative of wealth. And who is Brahma? Husband of Saraswati. Representative of knowledge, intellect. You should understand a basic truth. Neither by intellect nor by wealth you can achieve bliss. You can achieve God. Neither by intellect nor by wealth you can achieve God. You can't reach the ultimate neither through wealth nor through intellect. Second truth. If you try to achieve the bliss through wealth, at some point you will end up in success of depression and you will have a little bit of intelligence. There is a chance you may be saved. If you try to achieve the bliss through wealth, at some point after 50, once you get everything, whatever you want to have, you will face the success of depression. And there is a possibility for you to turn towards the God. There is a possibility for you to surrender. But if you work in the path of intellect, you will never be saved. If you go through the wealth, there is a chance of you falling into the success of depression. And you may turn, you may understand, I can't, I am done, enough. But when you go through the intellect, when you go through knowledge, not only you will not achieve, you will try to get some false witnesses to show, to prove you have achieved. The rituals are the false witnesses brought by the people who worked in the line of knowledge but who has not achieved the ultimate truth. Rituals are the tarambus. They have not achieved, but they wanted to show to the society they have achieved. The false witnesses, the wrong techniques and wrong rituals. You see, when rightly done, ritual itself will become meditation. Every puja starts with dhyana. When wrongly done, meditation itself will become ritual. The wrong techniques, the wrong rituals are the tarambus brought by the people who tried to achieve through the path of knowledge, intellect, and did not achieve. The wrong philosophies are the tarambus brought by the people who tried to achieve but did not achieve through the path of intellect. All these shat darshanas are the tarambus brought down by different people. People who work through the intellect, not only they don't achieve, they do not want to agree, they have not achieved. They are not achieved. The third lesson, flying high is rajas, going down is tamas. Neither tamas nor rajas can lead you to bliss, can lead you to God. Going up is rajas, going down is tamas. Neither tamas nor rajas can lead you to God. Brahma is the representative of logic, nyaya, a complete utter anyaya. Nyaya is the total anyaya. If the people who are caught in the Manipuraga, they gave nyaya as the solution, logic as the solution. They say, if you are a great dargi, if you can conquer anybody, you know the solution. Conquering is the solution. That is why goes on changing. Time to time, from place to place, and darga has no end. Darga is the nyaya, the logic.
Debates
has no end. Actually, let me narrate what is nyaya. Only then you will understand. I should give a simple basic introduction about all the philosophy. Only then you will understand how great Shiva is, how honest Shiva is. Unless I remove all the other things, all the other bushes, I will not be able to plant this Kalpa Vriksha in your heart. So now I am removing all the other bushes which exist in your mind in the name of Shastras, so that I can plant this Tantra in your heart. I am trying to show how Shiva has done a wonderful job by delivering this great Tantra, which is the gist of the essence of the whole spiritual philosophies. This is the book of books, unabridged dictionary of world philosophies and spirituality, Sutra of Sutras. What is Nyaya, you know? The people of Nyaya, how somebody is declared as a Pandit in Nyaya, you know, you will sit and start speaking. You will decide what question the other guy should ask. You will make him ask the question which you wanted. That is the way you will design your lecture. That is the way you should design your lecture. And the moment he puts the question, again you will answer. And in your answer itself, you will give it in a such a way, you should know what question he will ask. And again you will answer such a way, from that answer only you must be able to ask the next question. If you can manage the opposite person in the same way, 7 questions if you can make him ask as you wanted, you are a Darga Pandit, you are a Nyaya Pandit.